Hi, I'm Steve Higgins. I'm here to give you some advice. Let's see what we have here. This is from Anonymous. Anonymous asks, I like this boy in one of my classes. What should I do to initiate a conversation with him? Well, here's what I would do. Find out where he lives, how much his parents make for a living, what they do, and things like that. And then find a friend of yours. I'm sure since you're anonymous, you know these kind of people. Hack into their accounts. Find out what they do, what kind of movements they do, where they go on vacation, and things like that. Start slowly getting a dossier on this person. It might take you 5 to 15 years to really get a good picture of what this person's about, know where they're at, and slowly insinuate yourself into their lives. Like, bank at the same bank, happen to be on the same vacation, you know, find out where their investments are, you know, get in the news like that. You could also do a fake news case or start delivering a fake paper that you make yourself, or interrupt their internet feed and feed them stories that make yourself look good. Then about 10, 15 years of this, you go up to them and say, hey, you know what? Doesn't your dad invest in whatever corporation? And they'll go, why, yes, he does. And then you start up a conversation that way, and then it's all easy from there. Next one, this is from The Lavish Queen. She asked, Higgins, what is a good way to get out of babysitting my siblings? Well, here's what you could do. This is the simple answer. There's a lot of answers, but this is probably the easiest ones. When your parents are there around your kids, when you're around your siblings, just act like you're really sick. Feign an illness, feign a broken leg, go to the doctor, maybe get a fake cast, put it on, or what you could do is get clothes that are like sizes too big, incrementally. So you just go, I don't know, I'm not feeling so good. I think I'm losing a lot of weight. You start putting on these larger clothes and you just tell your mother, I think I'm shrinking, I'm freaking out. That way they'll never ask you to watch your little brother or sister. Camp Winnipesaukee asks, what are some good pickup lines to use on a guy I like? Well, you could go up to a guy you like and say, hey, you don't look that fat. I don't care what anybody says. That way you ingratiate yourself to him, making him think, oh wow, this person's, you know, honest, straight shooter. Or, wow, you're not as ugly as people say. Things like that, and that way the person, you demean their self-esteem, that way you can get in there to build them up to take them right back down again. Wiglet said, Higgins, what should I do if my favorite shirt is getting small, but I enjoy ice cream too much to stop eating it? Again, here's what you can do. This is a simple thing to all things. Whenever you buy clothing, buy 10 sizes up and 10 sizes down. That way, no one will know if you're putting on a few pounds or losing a few pounds. It might cost an extra 10 grand a week, but you know what? It's worth it. Killer Weasel said, what is the best way to deal with sunburn? I would say stay indoors at all times, maybe live in a basement or a cave. Cheese to the Cake asks, how do you get your dog to stop barking at everything and anything that goes by the house? This is very easy. You build a replica of your home in a soundstage or in a field with the wind, with the views are exactly matching what you would see across your street. These can be done with HD monitors or another set that is built. That way you control what goes by the house. So you want to get your dogs used to mailmen. You hire 15 to 100 mailmen to walk by until the dog gets bored and gets used to it. This might take a couple years, but I think it's worth it.